the people. Amen. And God give him an understanding heart. God give him wisdom. And God give him even the things that he have not asked for. There was another man in the Bible. He was going through a lot of pain, a lot of grief, and his name was Jabez. And the Bible said Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. And I believe why the Bible said he was more honorable than his brethren, because he called upon the Lord. Hallelujah. He called upon the Lord and he said, "Oh Lord God, will you bless me? Oh, bless me and bless me indeed. Enlarge my course and enlarge my territory," and whatever he has said. And the Bible goes on to say, and God grant him his request. So I say all of this just to say this. Bear in mind that you are serving a great, a big, and a wonderful God. A God that is all sufficient. A God that can do exceedingly abundantly above all your acts or think according to the power that is at work in you. So don't be afraid to ask God for great things. Don't be afraid to ask God for mighty things. Amen. Praise his wonderful name. Hallelujah. So let us just lift up our voice again. And this time around, we're going to intercede. Hallelujah. We're going to intercede on behalf of the people of Afghanistan. Hallelujah. Many are living in fear. Many are terrified of what, hallelujah, the Taliban will do. Although they have promised that they have granted amnesty to everyone. But still, there are many distrust and mistrust among the Afghan people toward the Taliban. So we're going to pray and bring that nation before God. And pray that everything will work out. That indeed war will cease and peace will return to the kingdom of Afghanistan. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, yea, these issues that beset Afghanistan, the things that are happening in that country at this junction in time, many are living in dread, living in fear. Yea, O God, in the name of Jesus, we are praying for peace and unity to be among the Afghan people. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that they will head down the way. Hallelujah, that will lead to peace. In the name of Jesus, that war will cease. In the name of Jesus, change will come to Afghanistan, that the wind of change will blow over Afghanistan and its inhabitants. In the name of Jesus, Father, protect those that need to be protected. Provide for those that need to be provided for. Father, grant those that need the assurance that it will be well, in the name of Jesus, so that they will come together and they will have a mind to work, that they will build up the country of Afghanistan. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Makata Shekalaba, Baba Shekalaba. lanta shakara la la sata she enkara la la sata she kara la 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 bo shabi vila taba ba ye enkara la la sata she kara la la bo shabi vila la bi shabi lete biba makata she kara la 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 sata. We bring the people of Afghanistan unto you today, Father. In the name of Jesus, we pray a blessing upon the nation of Afghanistan as they are about to embark on the new journey. In the name of Jesus, we pray for those that are in the governing establishment. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Mikalalalabo, Libi Bababo, Mikurobu Shadabo, Mishaba, Bishabaraki Alabo, Linti Biba, Makatalaba, Shakalalaba Sataye, Lady Shakalaba Sataye, Lambo Shakalaba Sata, Shakalaba, Makata, Yakalabo Sotom. Let your name be glorified, great God. Let your name be glorified, Mashakalaba Sambakalaba. Ekro soto shekalala, ekalala basamba kalala, ekalala bushebeba. In Jesus, mighty and wonderful name, we have concluded, based upon the Holy Scripture, that the heartbeat of God is for soul. Jesus commissioned them and he said, tarry in Jerusalem till the Holy Ghost shall come upon you. And when the Holy Ghost come upon you, you shall receive power and you shall be a witness unto me and to the uttermost part of the earth. So he was sending them forth to evangelize. He was sending them forth to be a witness. And I believe, according to the word of God that says in the book of Matthew, that we should pray unto the Lord of the harvest that he may send forth laborers in his vineyard. So we're going to pray to the Lord of the harvest today, that he might send forth laborers into his vineyard. Because he said the harvest is white, ready for harvest, but the laborers is few. So let us pray in the name of Jesus. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty and the awesome name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Yea, the whole duty of man is to fear you and to do your commandment. Yea, and you command us to go and make disciples of all nations. Yea, to go and preach the gospel to every creature. Yea, this gospel of the kingdom will be preached to the uttermost part of the earth, and then the end shall come. Father, Lord, we are praying. Oh yes, Lord of the harvest, may you send for laborers into your vineyard. In the name of Jesus, may you raise them up and send them forth into your vineyard. Makata shakalala boshela taye, ekalalaba ekalalaba sata ekalalaba. Divinely equip them, O God. In the name of Jesus, divinely enable them, O God. For the task you have called them unto, in the name of Jesus, that they will be able minister of the Spirit and not of the letter, for the letter killeth, but the Spirit giveth life. In the name of Jesus, they will be able minister of the New Testament. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, makata ye kalalala busoto ye kalalala. Oh Father, grant them utterance that they will speak boldly the mystery tree of the gospel. In the name of Jesus, that they may communicate the message that you have laid upon their heart. Grant them courage, grant them boldness, my Father, my God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, makete biba, latashi kararabu sotosha karara, ye kararabu sata, ye kararabu, that they will be steadfast. Now they will be unmovable, unshakable in the fear. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, masho kararabu sombo, that they will be heralds of good news. They will publish peace. Yeah, they will communicate the love of God unto a dying world. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, mashe bibliba, makata bakata la kuru shedi kalalaba hi kalalabu shebi lady kalalalaba samba. We pray that Lord, you will send forth laborers. Laborers in your harvest. Yea, then the word said you are in partnership with us. We are in partnership with you. We are co-laborers. We are fellow workers with you. My Father, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let your will be done in this department. Let your kingdom come where this is concerned. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we thank and we bless you and we praise and we glorify your mighty name. We are praying for those that are less fortunate, those that are deemed to be the outcast, the underprivileged, the disenfranchised of society, those that are down on their luck, or should I say, those that are downtrodden, those that need help. Hallelujah, those that are destitute, those that are homeless, those that are jobless. We are praying for the prostitute, the drunkard, the drugs addict. We are praying for these people. Oh, that God will intervene into their situation. That God will address the issues that confront and challenge them. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we remember them, dear God. In the name of Jesus, we remember the poor. In the name of Jesus, we intercede on their behalf. Father, they have different issues that they are dealing with. Different circumstances that confront and challenge them on a daily basis. Father, Lord, we know that you can do all things. We know that you are the great problem solver. You are the solution finder. And you say, call and you will answer. And while we yet speak, you will hear. Oh, we intercede on their behalf in the name of Jesus. That is that need to be readdressed, where their concern might be readdressed. In the name of Jesus, that you might step into their individual situation and begin to perfect that which concerning them. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, meet them at the point of their need, my Father, my God. Labu mi shavara mi mi karabu mi karaba lata shakarabu hi karabu shari. Lili kalalabu shari kalalabu shari kalalala lete bibe kete biba loto bi kalalabu shebiba mi kalalabu soto bibe biba lili bibe katolabu shebiba lili bi okorto lete bi lili biba kalalabu shebiba lili bi sete yi kalalabu shete bibe lili bi bi kalalabu soto mbakuntome yi kalalabu soto shebiba lili bi sete bibe. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we thank you again and we bless you again And we praise and we glorify His wonderful name. You see, it's such a wonderful thing, a glorious thing, when you are in a relationship with God, meaning that you can call and He will answer immediately. Amen.
Amen.
We see it in the Word of God that the moment some men of God call upon the Lord, instantaneously God answer. And I believe God want to have such a relationship with all of His children. Amen. He said, they shall know me from the least to the greatest. That mean every one of us will know Him. As water cover the sea, so shall His glory cover the land. The earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God. Hallelujah, the glory of God. Yeah, the glory of God, as we have said in the Lord's Prayer. He said, let thy kingdom come, let thy will be done. And I believe God wants His glory to be seen across the globe. Because that's what He said, as water cover the sea, so shall His glory cover the land. In the book of Isaiah 60, He say, arise. And that's what He's saying to us today. And shine. For our light has come. And the glory of the Lord has risen upon us. We have to take it by faith and believe that the glory of the Lord is upon us. There is something that is upon the believer. Hallelujah. There is something that resides and abides in the believer. There is a glory, and the Bible says Christ within us, the hope of glory. The glory that is to be revealed. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us just briefly go back in to the Word of God and read something else from the Word of God. And why am I doing this? Because the Bible says faith come by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. What you are hearing can empower you to believe that indeed God have done it for someone over this, so He can do it for you. Just reflecting back on Solomon, that even when God grace it Solomon, or the gift that God have given unto Solomon, he didn't know that he have received it until it begin to manifest and other people begin to see and identify. And I believe that God, whatever He do in your life, it will be evidently clear to others. And others will begin to identify and point out that indeed God is working with you in this manner or in that manner. Praise Master Jesus. What I'm saying, you know, brothers and sisters, is just to encourage us. Because Jesus said it, and Jesus is the truth, that means He speak true word. Lying become an abomination to His lip. That means He won't speak things that are untrue. And He says the works that He have done, they who believe in Him, They shall also do and greater works. So this is not a pride trip that I am on. But because the Lord have said it, then I believe it. And I am expecting to receive the reality of what he have spoken about. Because he said they who believe in him. Amen. So you have to ask yourself this question. Do you believe in him? And if you believe in him, then it's only right and fitting that you also expect what Jesus said to come to pass in your life. I'm reading something from the book of St. Mark 5. And I will take it from verse 22. And behold, there cometh one of the ruler of the synagogue, Jairus by name. And when he saw him, he fell at his feet and besought him greatly, saying, my little daughter lie at the point of death. I pray thee, come and lay thy hands on her, that she may live, that she may be healed. And Jesus went with him, and much people followed him and thronged him. And a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years, and had suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and was nothing better, but rather grew worse, when she heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. For she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be whole. And straight away the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. And Jesus immediately, knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turn him about in the press and said, who touched my clothes? And his disciples said unto him, thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and sayest, who touched me? And he looked round about to see her that had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, and knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him and told him all the truth. And he said unto her, daughter, thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace and be whole of thy plague. Such a beautiful end to a story. That this woman, she knew definitely that what she was about to do was illegal. It was wrong for such a person to be touching a holy man. But nevertheless, she said in her heart, if I could only touch, not his person, you know, but just the hem of his garment, I shall be healed. And her feet were being honored. Amen. So remember, my brothers and sisters, wherever in the world you are at this junction in time, that these things that have been done in time past, the Lord Jesus is saying to you and I that greater things we will be able to do because he have gone to his Father. So you can also believe God Because the Bible says Abraham believed God and it was imputed to him for righteousness. So if you will also believe today, God will declare you righteous if you choose to believe the report and accept the report that indeed one day that you will do according to what Jesus has said that you will do because you are a believer. Please, Master Jesus, we're going to lift up our voice again and pray. And we're going to pray earnestly. For it's the Father's good pleasure to give you and I the kingdom. And the Bible said nothing good with thee withhold from them that walk uprightly. And we got to believe we are the upright. Yeah, we got to believe we are the righteous. We are the just. So we must believe that he's speaking to you and I. So let us pray. Sincerely asking God that he will bring his word to pass in our life. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, my shakarai karalarabusoto. Ikalarabasata shakarabusoto, my yelabusata ye. Ikalarabasata ye lebi baba baba ye kalarabasotombo. Is you who are promised that when the Holy Ghost shall come upon us, we shall receive power. It is you that have promised, Makata Sheikh, Lalalabasata, yeah. Oh, that your people will be willing in the day of your power. It is you that have promised, Mashaikh, Lalalabasata, yeah, Letebe Bakata, yeah. That we should call and you will answer. Yea, while we yet speak, you will hear, Makata Shakata. That you will show great and mighty things that we have not known. Mashe bibile bibibi ba 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 ye kalalalaba mama. Nele te mimile mimikata. They who believe in you, they shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. They who believe in you, they shall cast out devils. They who believe in you shall speak with new tongues. Mashakatamba yelabo unto mushabibilebebebekete. And all the promises of God in Christ Jesus is yea and in him amen. To them that believe, and we are the believer. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father, there is a need. There is a cause, oh God. That's why we are saying, send forth the anointing. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, unleash your holy power. In the name of Jesus, that the excellency of the power might not be a first birth of God. In the name of Jesus, Mashi Bibilibiba. Milete biba lata samba hanta ye lete biba. They that hunger and thirst for righteousness shall be filled. Makata ye lete biba katamba kente me kalalalaba sata ye. That you satisfy the longing soul and fill the hungry soul with goodness. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you are the one that truly satisfy. Yea, my Father, my God, you said they who follow you shall never hunger, neither shall they thirst. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Mashe Bibile biba. E carta, e corto, mimike te that the desire of the righteous shall be granted and the expectation shall not be cut off. In the name of Jesus, as we look unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our fiat, maye lataye. Nilata baba baba busha baba unto me. E karara busha bibli bibi karara busoto. E karara basata ye lete bibakata. We need it, O God. We require that which you have for us, O God. In the name of Jesus, that it might come to fruition. It might come to pass. That it might be established in our life. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, maye lete, lete, mime, mikete, mimikete. Yea, for every good and perfect gift come from the Father above. Oh, there is no variableness, no shadow of turning. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, mashe bibilebiba. And the word said, you give severally as you will, as you choose, makata ye. Every gift that lie dormant within us, let it be activated right now. In the name of Jesus, we store up those gifts right now. In the name of Jesus, we will not neglect the gift that is in us. In the name of Jesus, and we are praying, my Father, my God, let the gift begin to work. Let the gift be operational, be functional in the name of Jesus, that our light will shine forth and man might see and give glory to our Father in heaven. My elebi lata baba ba ye kalalabo soto she kalalabo it is she bibli debi satai. You said he who come to you must believe that you is and you is a reward of them that diligently seek you. We ask in faith and believing that we will receive that which we have asked, that which you have spoken in regarding to us, that you will do, that you will bring your word to pass, bring your word into manifestation. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Jabez, he prayed unto you, and the Bible said you grant him his request. In the name of Jesus, you don't show partiality nor favoritism, and use no respecter of person. What you do for one, you can do for the other. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we are asking, for you said we should ask that our joy might be full. We are asking that you might do new things in our life. Let it spring forth. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, usher in a change, my Father, my God. We thank and bless you. We praise and we glorify your mighty name. And Father, bless your people. And bless your people wherever they are located, situated at this junction in time, geographically speaking, dear God. And whenever they will watch this telecast, I pray a blessing over their life. And I decree wealth manifestation. And I decree health manifestation. Let the wealth of the wicked that is